The NFL just sold out to racist players by giving each one a massive gift for scandalous reason. The more the NFL tries to dig itself out of the mess it got into with patriotic America-loving fans, the more they land back flat on their idiotic faces. This time in an effort to put an end to the ungrateful ball-tossing millionaire protests during the national anthem, it's being reported the NFL has proposed partnering with its players to effect so-called social justice change. According to the leftist propaganda machine that is ESPN, the league has now submitted to players the final draft of a proposal that would donate nearly $100 million to causes considered important to African American communities. But it seems some players don't think it's enough. Really, now you will pay these scumbags to stand? How will $100 million make the fathers of the 78% of black babies born to fatherless households take responsibility? Confirmed, NFL losing millions of TV viewers because of national anthem protests. A headline for a story in the sporting news this morning, shock poll, a third of NFL TV viewers boycotting games because of Colin Kaepernick-led protests. Shock? Why? The sporting news article says nearly one-third, 32%, of adults say they're less likely to watch NFL game telecasts because of the Kaepernick-led player protests against racial injustice, according to Rasmussen's Telephone, online survey of 1,000 American adults conducted October 2 to 3. Only 13% said they were more likely to watch an NFL game because of continuing protests by Kaepernick and supporters such as Antonio Cromartie of the Colts, who was cut only 2 days after raising a fist during the playing of the Star-Spangled Banner in London on Sunday. Equals. This was very predictable. 3 weeks ago I wrote that the national anthem protests that began with San Francisco 49ers QB Colin Kaepernick and has since been copied by other players have angered many fans. And that anger may be one reason why the television ratings for the first week of NFL games were bad. As my colleague, Brandon Katz wrote, both CBS Sunday afternoon game and NBC's Sunday Night Football saw their lowest ratings in 7 years. Throw in last night's lackluster debut and the 2016 NFL season is off to its slowest start in recent memory in terms of TV ratings. 2 weeks ago I wrote it is starting to look like disrespecting the country during the national anthem is accomplishing what the concussions, domestic violence and a flaggate could not do drive down television ratings for the National Football League. Through 2 weeks of football the NFL's television ratings are down across the board. The drop in ratings and viewership is unprecedented in recent years and has occurred during the protest of the national anthem, started by San Francisco 49ers backup QB Colin Kaepernick. Just last year some opined that the league's ratings had no ceiling. That appears to be false. And last week I explained that there can be no more excuses for the bad ratings, like the one offered by Billy Gold, vice president and director of programming research at Amplify, the global buying arm of media company the Dentsu Aegis Network, who said it's the bad NFL TV ratings, the lack of big games and prominent names that have sacked the league the past 2 weeks. Nonsense. Something more visceral is causing ratings to fall. My opinion, fans are ticked about the players protesting the national anthem. This morning it was confirmed by the fact that through 4 weeks, good games and bad, games with marquee quarterbacks and big markets, ratings are way down this year. This poll is predictable, not shocking. Who will ultimately pay if the ratings continue to sink? The players and owners. The National Football League will rake in roughly $4.6 billion in television fees from CBS, CBS plus 1.85%, Walt Disney owned ESPN, Comcast owned NBC, Fox and DirecTV that it will equally share with its 32 teams this year. The NFL commands such a rich bounty because advertisers pay up for football's huge ratings. The television money is a big reason why the average NFL team is worth $2.34 billion and the average NFL player earns $2.1 million. The networks that televise the games barely mention the protests anymore. But the fans have not forgotten. The only reason all this mess even started was because Colin Kaepernick began kneeling because he was for all intents and purposes, on his way out of the NFL. He knew this so his Muslim girlfriend, who has deep ties to Islamic extremism, convinced him to pull a stunt like this. He never had an issue with any so-called cop brutality, and he never hated our flag while he was actually still an active player for the San Francisco 49ers. The bottom line here is that no matter what narrative the left-wing media tries to spin to explain the NFL's sagging ratings, people as a whole don't like what these spoiled players or the NFL are doing. ESPN has gone as far as calling this drop in numbers NFL fatigue. But if that was the case, then NFL stadiums wouldn't be half, or more, empty, while college football stadiums are practically full and have not suffered any decline in viewership or attendance whatsoever. In fact, most game ratings have actually skyrocketed during this season.